Let's get you into something more comfortable.
What?
Oh. I'll be taking the liberty of changing your garments as I see fit. Ah, that's better. I want you looking like a proper Zoroshin when I'm gone.
What was that?
It looked like a crab.
Who are you?
Who I am is not important right now. What is important is who you are and what you are capable of.
What? Gossick? Who is that? Was that really Guthix? How could he possibly die?
I sometimes find myself asking that same question, but then I remember that technically he's still just a very powerful mortal, as Zaros would say.
Zaros? He's alive? What happened to him?
Anything I might tell you of Zaros would simply become a trivial fixation distracting you from true understanding. Besides, there are other pieces with which you could familiarize yourself. Rest easy.
Why was that mole so big?
That is an example of how the anima of this world is becoming distorted. The nature of some beings is escaping them, and they are no longer calm. But every action has a reaction. If moles are being altered that way, this world's anima will have a response to balance that.
Like what? Whoa, what was with all those skeletons?
That is an example of your world's response to balance how the anima is affecting the moles.
What do you mean?
There is a certain balance to this world which is fluid and reacts to how certain events unfold. Originally, this balance was disturbed several thousand years ago when certain beings ascended and claimed divine right. You may recognize them as the gods of this world, however I identify them by a slightly less venerable title. Opportunistic usurpers of power, parasites who feed on wounds in the anima of this world.
You speak as though you have an uneasy history with them. Do you know the gods?
I am familiar with them.
So Ceridoman and Xanarak have returned.
Indeed, and as you can see, they care little for the collateral damage which is a result of their business dealings on Gielinor. As insignificant and superficial the damage you witnessed may seem, the effect on Gielinor is much more profound. Essentially, Xamorak and Ceridoman opposed each other equally. But now with Ceridoman stronger and Xamorak weaker, that balance is upset once again. Under somewhat normal circumstances, Gielinor would have been balanced after an event such as the spawning of skeleton hordes. However, if the meddling of the Ascendant has disturbed even the enchantments of the Dragonkin and has awoken the Queen Black Dragon, a response of equal proportions is likely to manifest.
Hello, little one.
Hello.
It is not often I get visitors.
What are you doing here?
I am waiting.
Waiting for what?
Waiting to defend against what is to come.
What is to come?
You will discover that soon enough. In the meantime, search out these anomalies. Whether they realize it or not, Ixalaran and Death now have a personal interest in your purpose, which should inspire you. But I have other matters to attend to now.
So you're just gonna leave like that?
Yes.
What?
It has been long enough, my dear friend.
This must be part of the damage to Gielinor's anima. There is more to this than is apparent. This feels like a pathway or a connection of some sort. Whoa! Oh, this is the crater the gods made. It seems as though entering the world of the gods causes my own world to disappear.
You have questions.